There we go.
Resonator delete. Driveway style.
All right, so first thing we're gonna do up top is we're going to find the O2 sensor, which is right here. So we're gonna detach it from its clips and then we're gonna unplug it. So you can see I'm just basically working through all these clips. Pull that out. Pull that out. Pull that out and then pop this free. And then we're just going to push down here and unplug it. All right, so now this is a 6mm Allen. We're gonna loosen this up and this is gonna separate the downpipe from the turbocharger hot side. So this is the turbocharger's hot side right here. This is the downpipe here. And this is the V-band clamp that connects the two. That's a little too hot for me to touch right now. Touch it quickly. Loosen that up and I'm gonna pop that loose with a flathead screwdriver. So real simple, just get in there, kind of separate the two. I'm just gonna pop the V-band clamp over top of the hot side of the turbo just to get it out of the way. So at this point, the downpipe can separate, but it's mounted pretty solidly to the block. So now it's time to get underneath and start loosening up some of those mounts underneath. All right, so the next step we're gonna do is we're gonna just remove this brace. We don't really need to do this, but it's just gonna give us a little bit more room, and since we're replacing the resonator anyway, it's gonna allow us to drop all this stuff down. These are 13mm bolts. All right, now we are going to remove this front mount right here. So looking at this, this is basically what mounts the rubber mounts to the subframe and also holds the bottom portion of this downpipe. Again, these are 13mm. And that allows this to move below the flex pipe. So now the final piece, the final two pieces we need to do is we need to separate this clamp right here. So we're gonna put some wrenches on that, and then we're going to slide this either forward or backwards, this over clamp. And then there's also one bolt that bolts the downpipe to the engine itself. We're going to see if that's easier to access from the bottom or top. I'm thinking it's probably going to be easier to access from the top. So we have a 13mm socket where you can't see it on top of this, and we're going to be loosening this up. This is a little tricky to get to. Sorry for the poor camera angle, but. And now moving back to the rear one. All right, now I like to take this, wiggle it, and slide it right off. And now we've separated the resonator from the downpipe and the catalytic converter. So like I said, we're gonna go back up, and we're gonna find that one 13mm that holds the downpipe to the engine block, and we'll remove that, and then we'll be able to start finagling this downpipe out from under here without damaging this heat shield. All right, so this is, basically I'm going to, right where the seam of the downpipe and the turbo are, and then going straight down, there's a stud sticking out of the back of the engine block. And I can actually feel it as I burn my forearm on the downpipe. Ow, again, ow, again. And now I'm on it with the wrench, but I can't quite turn it. This stuff is hot. Here, so this is the seam between the turbocharger. So the hot side of the turbo is gonna sit right where my hand is, right here. This is where the V-band clamp is gonna be, where we loosened up the 6mm Allen. And so there's gonna be a 13mm coming right out of the back of the engine, and there's gonna be a nut right there that we're gonna have to loosen up. This is almost impossible to see, because looking up, you gotta look through the flex pipe. Looking down, you have the turbo here. So this is a matter of what we're gonna do is we're gonna reach behind the back of the engine, we're gonna feel it, then we'll get a wrench on it, and we'll be able to turn it with a wrench and back it out. Nice, make some progress. So this is a 13mm on a tiny little extension. And it looks like we've gotten some progress to the point where I can take the socket off. Just do it by hand.
So all that for this little guy. So right now the downpipe should be free. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make sure we get it separated from the top, and then we're gonna finagle it down from the bottom. Looks like there's a second one that's not on the aftermarket one, but it's directly down off this elbow. So I'm gonna see if I can get to it from this angle. Oh, sweet. And we are separated. So right now we're separated from the turbo. I can see inside the turbo, I can see we're separated from the clamp. So my goal right now is I'm gonna go under the car and I'm gonna finagle this down. But my big, the big important strategy here is to not damage the exhaust, the O2 sensor, the exhaust gas sensor. So I'm just gonna basically just bring it down nice and carefully without smashing that in and without ruining any of the beautiful heat shielding that sits against the firewall. And we should be able to do that. So let's go under the car. So really I'm just kind of caressing it back. I have my hand on the O2 sensor to make sure it doesn't get damaged. And slowly working it over top of the steering rack heat shield. Rotating the whole thing out. And rotating the existing catalytic converter over towards the passenger side, and basically rotate the whole thing out like this. Right now, my exhaust, my O2 sensor plug, it seems to be caught in something, so I'm gonna have to go check that out. All right, here we are laying under the car. We're gonna get the downpipe out for the last time. So again, we're just gonna kind of snail it out by bringing it out to the passenger side of the car. As we rotate it down. Watch your face as we come through here. Here we are, we're out. So let's get those out from underneath the car and we'll take a good look at it after that. Next step, we have the 034 downpipe here. The stock downpipe here, you can see the huge difference in diameters. I mean, for instance, look at this. So entry is about the same, but we have a racing cat here versus a standard cat. We also have, look at this, look how much more fluid this is here compared to this little bit here. And then the diameter change right here. Obviously we're gonna have to switch this mount over to here. And then we're gonna have to switch the oxygen sensor from here and take this plug out. So first things first, we're gonna take our 22. We're gonna get this oxygen sensor loose. This is a matter of just kind of jamming it down on the ground a little bit here and give it a couple whaps. It actually came out a lot easier than I expected it to. So we have our oxygen sensor. Next step is we're going to take a 10 millimeter Allen. And we're going to take this plug out. All right, so plugs out. I'm actually just gonna install it here just to hold on to it so we don't lose it. All right, so to make installation a little easier, I'm actually gonna leave the oxygen sensor out of this to get it up in there so I don't have to worry about damaging it. And then we can just thread it in by hand and give it a quick snug. Now we're gonna switch over the exhaust mount. So this is really a matter of just put some force on it and give it a proper wiggle. Just kind of let it work its way right over the edge. Bonk. Nice. Again here. Bonk. So installing this on here, you'll see that these bolt holes actually sit a little higher. So you're going to want to make sure that it's oriented in this direction. So these bolt holes will sit a little higher than these and really just massage it right on to the mounts. All right. So we have that good. We'll take our little extender off, make this as small as possible to get up there. Let's go get this thing installed. Now, a quick note, you'll notice there's two ears here that both mount in on the standard one. Now, switching over to the 034, there's only going to be one ear. So we're going to have to worry about putting one fastener on there. So let's do it. Let's crawl under the car and get this thing installed. All right, let's do this. We got our 034 downpipe here. We're going to finagle it in pretty much the same way that it came out. So curve it in. Now rotate it around. This is obviously a lot easier going back in. It's significantly smaller than the standard one. And I'm gonna send my arm up here. Make sure we get it all right on the mount. On the mount and installed. That was a piece of cake. I'll take these two mounts, these two 13 millimeters here. I'm just gonna put these in finger tight, just hold it in position, and we're gonna move back up top. And when we're up top, we'll make sure everything is fully secure and tight, and then we'll come back down and finish up the exhaust system. That was incredibly easy, considering I'm laying on my back. This is totally a job you can do in your driveway. Block off maybe a Saturday morning. Easy peasy. I also note, look at the fitment on this. Right to the edge, make sure we're not gonna hit that heat shield. I'm gonna push some of this out of the way a little bit. Last thing you want is your exhaust system banging on your heat shield, but yeah, really nice fitment. So super excited, it's gonna go nice and tight against the turbo. Let's get up there and finish this thing up. All right, so the next step, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put on finger tight the bracket bolt that holds the downpipe to the bracket that's bolted to the engine block. I'm not gonna go wrench this down, I'm just gonna get it snug and hold up there. Then we're gonna put the V-band clamp on, because what we don't wanna do is we don't put any tension on the turbo. So we wanna make sure that the V-band clamp determines where the downpipe actually sits. So I'm reaching down right below the turbocharger seam, basically right here. I can feel the stud sticking out. And now I'm just putting the 13 millimeter nut on that. And I'm just gonna thread this in by hand. So let's make sure we don't forget to tighten this down, but just get it by hand. And now this can still move around. We can still get this aligned properly to the turbo. And I'm gonna take the V-band clamp, make sure that we're seated 360 degrees around this seam. And also making sure we're in a position where we can tighten the bolt down. So you can see I'm double checking this seam is completely sealed up. We're a little off in the bottom, I can feel it. So I'm just gonna wiggle this thing around, make sure we get a good seat. All right, move this to the side, let's do this again. Didn't get the seat I wanted. All right, we're seated on the gasket. Oh, we were seated on the gasket. A little bit of force working against me here, so. All right, now we're nice and snug. All right, that looks good snug. Now using the 6 millimeter Allen, come through the back, I'm gonna snug this down. Again, really cool how you see this. Now we wanna make sure that this is the first thing we actually snug down regarding the downpipe, and we wanna make sure we don't tighten this too tight. I'm reaching around, making sure that we have a full engagement all the way around. So now I'm gonna take a 13 millimeter and the nut that I tightened down finger tight, I'm gonna actually tighten down with a socket. Hindsight, put your O2 sensor on your downpipe before you install it. There's plenty of room to install it. I was worried about damaging it on the install. I would screw it in while you have it on the floor and then just install the downpipe. Be much easier. So first thing, the wire goes around here. This keeps it away from the downpipe. Doesn't get too hot, pulls it right away. And then we are going to go through all of these clamps. So first clamp, set it right on top and then clip the clamp shut. Right there. Second clamp, third clamp. And then finally, we plug it in. So right here, let's see, it goes like this. Plug it in, and then this whole assembly slid in like that. And just make sure it's up and out of the way. Nicely tucked in, away from the heat of the turbo. We should be good to go. All right, now moving underneath the car, we're gonna grab our 13 millimeter on a socket, and we're gonna basically go down and snug everything up. Then I'm gonna move back, and we're gonna take the resonator. We're actually gonna unbolt the resonator, and we're gonna use the resonator delete pipe. Get this whole thing buttoned up, put a tune on it, and we'll start it up. Yep. So snugging down this mount to the subframe. So right now we have the downpipe installed, flex pipe's good. So at this point, we're going to unbolt the resonator here, and then we're gonna put the resonator delete in. So if we were not installing a resonator delete on it, this would go right here with an 80 millimeter clamp around it. So just like that. And then right on the end of this here, we'd have the reducer, which would go right into this resonator. We are going to replace this resonator with the 034 Motorsport resonator delete kit, which is gonna just be a straight pipe through here. But this would be the downpipe installed to an original system for the rest of the way. Let's go install our 034 resonator delete kit. So basically I'm lining everything up next to the car that I'm gonna need. I got my Sharpie, got my Sawzall with a brand new metal blade on it, got the ResX. And then because we're running the 034 downpipe, I got my reducer. Just gonna go up front, so this is actually backwards. It's gonna go like this. This is gonna go on the back. This is gonna go on the front. Everything's lined up. I'm gonna go under there. Basically what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hold the resonator delete pipe up to where it's gonna go. Take my Sharpie, I'm gonna mark right at where the end of this is. There's a lot of room there. We're gonna take our Sawzall, we're gonna slice through, remove the standard resonator, install this setup. We're gonna start this car up, see what it sounds like. I got my 13 under there. I'm gonna take off that rear bracket. We should be good to go. Oh, my shoulder doesn't fit there. There we go. Let's get this brace off here. So, double 13s. All right. Brackets off. Set aside. All right, so here's the resonator as it stands now. We have the downpipe installed. So, you got the reducer here. So, that's gonna go on right here. Something like that. So, and obviously this can get moved. So just kind of mocking this whole thing up. This is how it would normally be installed, but obviously we're gonna delete this resonator. So we're gonna take this length and we're gonna figure out exactly where we need to cut it somewhere along here. And obviously you can see there's plenty of room. We gotta watch out for the fuel tank, but there's plenty of room around that. So now we have the Sharpie and the resonator. You can see there's a mount right here. So this is where this mount is gonna basically line up. So we're looking at right there. That's about where this is gonna be. We don't have to be super, super perfect. There's a little bit of wiggle room. This would be a great opportunity for a friend to give you a little mark. Let's give it a little mark right there.
Right here?
Yep, right there. We have a mark here. I'm gonna give us a little bit of wiggle room just so we can use the clamp properly. You can always make up a little bit of a gap. So say right about there. Give us about a 10 millimeter, 1 centimeter gap there. And now we're gonna start cutting. So the first thing you wanna do is check what you have around you. So we have a fuel tank here. So we wanna make sure we don't cut into the fuel tank. So I'm gonna position the saw in a way where I can cut through it this way. We also wanna make sure that the blade of the saw isn't gonna hit into anything. And then the last little bit is obviously position ourselves the best we can. We're just double checking our markings, make sure we're good. Get our saws all ready. See, I'm cycling through, make sure I'm not hitting anything. And I'm gonna start cutting. Make sure you have some good blades because stainless steel is pretty hard, likes to eat up blades pretty quickly. This is always the hardest part, is getting it started. And once you get a groove cut, it actually really nice, makes it pretty easy work, but getting it started is always tricky. All right, you guys ready to finish this up? Let's do it. looks like we're almost all the way through. To make this a little easier on yourself, sometimes it's easier just to actually break the exhaust system off by wiggling it. Give it a couple wiggles, and we're free. Now I'm gonna wiggle it out of the mount without busting it into my face. There we go.
Resonator delete. Driveway style.
I want to hear this thing run, man. All right, so looking at this, looks like we're relatively straight, and it looks like we should be good to go. So I'm just gonna put this through this mount here. This is sort of a test fit phase, just to make sure everything's gonna fit properly. All right, we're through there. All right, butt it up front. Rear. We're good. Looks like we're gonna slide some clamps over top of both ends. Matt, can you go look at the tips, the muffler tips real quick with the camera? And just make sure that they're lined up and they're not getting pushed to one side or anything. Well, those are the things you're gonna wanna check, is to make sure everything's lined up, nothing's rubbing. Looks like everything's good. So we're gonna start clamping this thing up and get it ready to go. First off, this is going to connect the muffler to the resonator delete pipe over here. So I'm gonna slide this on, make sure that the bolts are facing in a direction that you can have access to them, whether it's up or down, doesn't really matter. But so slide that over there. And then I need the one that was on the original resonator, because we're going to reuse that one for the front. And then the last little bit I need is one of those 80 millimeter clamps. So right now I'm just sliding the clamps to try to get this thing close where it needs to be. We could always make fine tuning adjustments afterwards, but and same with this one. Make sure these are butted together nicely. That clamp is over top of it. I may actually rotate this clamp around so I have the fasteners underneath, just to make it a little easier to zip it on and off if need be. So we'll do that. Take this clamp off. Just like that. Nice. This is a good place to use that jack stand you had and just hold the exhaust system in the orientation that you wanted it to be in. Don't forget about this jack stand when you let it down off the jack, though. That would be embarrassing. So I can feel those two pipes touching together. So what I want to do, a little trick here, where's my Sharpie? I'm going to look at this seam here. I'm going to take about what half of this is right here, and I'm going to put a mark on here. So this is about halfway around there. So now, when I bring this up and I slide this clamp over, I know exactly how far the clamp needs to go to have equal coverage on both pieces of pipe. Right there. You can see this is nicely aligned. We're pretty well aligned over here. I'm going to do the same thing with this clamp. So I really want to get it to at least about there. All right, now we're gonna tighten all these down. And the moment of truth, just around the corner. We're gonna start this thing up, see what it sounds like. All right, so we're gonna tighten this one first, get this nice and straight, and then we'll tighten that one second. Leaving these two joints to give us some adjustability if we need. So. The clamps will actually center the exhaust system quite a bit on their own. You can feel this thing really stiffening up and getting solid in here. Okay, now we're gonna do the same over here. Make sure these pipes are together. You can see they separated a little bit, so I'm just gonna pull them in a little bit together. Make sure we're good and snug. really nice and stiff. This thing's really coming together nicely. I take this center clamp or this stand off. Look at that. Really not going anywhere. Let me snug these down. Good and stiff. Good and snug here. All right, so now we have these two up here. So just verifying that nothing's hitting anything. I'm wiggling a little bit, make sure we're not hearing any knocks. I'm gonna tighten these two with a 17 millimeter. Start in the back. I wanna get this clamp positioned nicely right on the edge of the pipe so we get a good purchase on it. All right, tightening down the last clamp, making sure we're good and snug. Now we're gonna go reinstall this brace and the back brace, and we're good to go, man. So let's install this rear brace here. Pull the plastic down a little bit. Nice clearance between the exhaust system and the brace. So we're not gonna hear any rubbing there. Just dropping a couple nuts. So even if I pull down, it doesn't hit that. Something you wanna make sure. These exhaust systems tend to move around quite a bit. Snug. Grab my socket, my 13. And now to the front brace. Kick it into myself. This may need to move, we may need to adjust it up a teeny bit. Make sure we don't hit this. Last thing you need is an exhaust system rubbing. All right, so what I'm noticing here is that we're getting really close where we can almost touch. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna loosen this and swivel this whole thing up. I have plenty of room up here, just to make sure we don't have any contact with the bracing or the floor with the exhaust system, because you're going to notice that when you're driving down the road. All right, let me grab my 17. So to make slight tweak adjustments like I'm talking about to this exhaust system, I'm simply going to loosen this up right here. Give it a couple turns, and I'm going to loosen this one up. Give this a couple turns, and then I'm just gonna give this whole thing a shove up. This clamp isn't separating. So just loosen that clamp up. Loosen that clamp up. Now I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna rotate it, just like that. So now I have a proper inch or so of clearance here. So that made a big difference. So now I'm just gonna snug everything back down again. Give it a good shake. Nothing's hitting anything. Let's go see what this thing sounds like.
So
this is gonna be fun. Let's get a tune on it. Oh, listen to that over. This is like streetcar TCR. This is like I can go on a date, yet I get all the little smiles that I get in TCR.